Bhagwan's divine feet. And a very, very warm welcome to all of you over here to introduce our very special guest who we have amidst us today. Unke naam se zyada, unki karm ki mahanta unka parichay deti hai. They are Bhagwan's true instruments of service. Why? Because the essence of their lives is Bhagwan's mission, Bhagwan's word, Bhagwan's message. With utmost respect and love, we welcome you, Srimati Kamala Pandya ji, and you must be aware now, she is National Coordinator, Mahila Vibhag, and Neeta Didi, Ms. Neeta Khanna ji, is National Coordinator, Bal Vikas. Let's show her action. I would like to call Ms. Abrina Chima ji on stage. I would also like to call on stage Ms. Babita Kapoor ji. I now request Kamala aunty kindly come up here and bless us with your words of wisdom. We would, and please share with us your experiences and your guidance. How should we move forward? And how we can be as sincere, or maybe even if just a bit, as you are in Bhagwan's service. Kamala Pandya ji.
Om Shri Sai Ram. So it's very surprising, and in fact it's God's grace, that we must start our spiritual journey right from the capital of the country, and that is Delhi. So the first meeting after last week's announcement on Guru Purnima, of the changes that have taken place all over the country, which you are aware of. Anybody not aware of the changes in your state? Are you aware of it?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So, having known that, I'm here today to just find out what is the pulse of the Mahilas. What do you feel about these changes? And what are the areas you want us to concentrate more on? Why am I here for that? Is because I don't want, now that we are with you, any murmuring to take place behind. If you have any problems in your mind, share it with us. Because remember, we are not on the other side, we are with you. And that's why the mic didn't work when I was on the other side. And God saw that I came in front, so that we are just one family. Because our relationship with many of you has been on a one-to-one basis. It's not like this is somebody sitting, standing on a pedestal. No. In fact, we have been very casual with all of you. Our days with Delhi goes back to our dear Nimi aunty, who has been with us in the Bal Vikas right from the time I was just married and when I came in. Because my story with Bhagwan started at the age of 3. When I was barely 3 years old, I had my first interview with Bhagwan. And when I got married thereafter by Bhagwan itself, it was Bhagwan who mentioned to us at the wedding interview that I have great plans for you. I didn't know at that time what were those plans. But today I see it unveiling in front of us, that Bhagwan had this plan, but we must help our Mahilas as well as the gents to join hands together and make this mission possible. It's very difficult now with the physical form not being there. When the physical form was there, it was easy because numbers were there, people were coming, but there has been a little lacuna, a little time lapse, but now today again we find, at least in the last Guru Purnima program we found, that there were numbers swelling back into Prashanti Nilayam. And that's a very good sign. So therefore, let's keep our hands together, let's keep our minds together, and if you have anything in your heart, let's be frank to share it with one another. Because we have come for Sai, and we must go back with Sai in our hands. So this is the message that I want to share with you, that whenever you have a problem, whenever you have a problem, remember to add the Sai principle in your life. That should be your guiding factor. If I have a problem in my life, let me put Sai in my life. If Sai was there with me, what would I have done? And let me share with you a small anecdote that will drive this lesson better. Being a lawyer by profession, again, that itself is one's direction to me. I was a teacher before marriage, and as soon as I got married, Swami said, not teacher, now you become a lawyer, study law. So I studied law after marriage, and within 3 years, Swami kept pestering husband to help karo. So I took up law in Bombay University, studied law, and qualified with a gold medal from Bombay University. I still don't like taking law. It sort of rebels in me, because there are so many things which is not what Swami would have wanted us to do, and which hurts us. But because the Lord wanted it, I took it up. So when I took it up, there's a beautiful story which I'd like to share with you. An old man came to me and said, ma'am, I want to prepare my will. My last will and testament. Vasiyat nama jo kehte hai na, I want you to help me prepare. I said, very good. So easy. I'll do it for you, sir. Tell me what you have, whom you're going to give what to, and I'll prepare this for you. So he said, see, you know, I'm a widow. My wife passed away. I have a son, Raju, who stays with me. I have a servant boy, Ramu, who looks after me. And every evening, I go to Dharmakshetra, which is close by, to spend my evenings there. Also, I have 19 horses with me. I said, fine. And whom do you want to give what to? He said, very simple. Give 50% of my horses to my son, Raju. Give 20% of my horses to my servant, Ramu. Then, so you have 50 and 20% over. Then, that means you have given already the cream of your assets to your son and your servant. And the balance amount you give to the Dharmakshetra Trust, because I spend every evening over there and we'll be happy to see that money goes for a good cause. And I said, whom do you want to have help you in executing this will? So he said, you'll ask Kamini to help, put her name and let her be the executress. So I said, fine. I said, on so and so day, we'll sign the document, but bring two witnesses with you. So he said, fine, ma'am. So he got Shivani and he got Divya. And in the presence of all of us, we signed the document. And the document said that Kamini would execute the will, Shivani and Divya would be the witnesses to the will, and as per his dictates, everything was written. A few days pass and the old man breathes his last. So the will was with Kamini. A copy of the will was with Kamini. She opened it. And as soon as she opened it, she said, oh God, on the first line it said, the lawyer has made a mistake. Now where do I go up to ask that man, what do I do with his will? She said, see, it writes there that I have 19 horses. Give 50% of those horses to my son. Who is my son? Raj. 50% of 19. There itself is a problem. 50% of 19 is 9.5. How do I do this? How do I slaughter a horse into two parts and do this? So she sat at the corner of the Dharmakshetra circle with the hands on her head and said, "Oh God, now what?" And there at that time came another man, a wise man, riding on a horseback. He said, "Kamali, what's happened to you? Why are you so upset?" So she said, "See, the lawyer has done this, the man has gone up, now what do I do?" He said, "Don't worry, call the 19 horses. So all the 19 horses were made to line up. The king and she, and he got up from one horse and put that 20th horse. Now he said, distribute. And she did it. 50% of 20?
10.
So 10 went to Raju. Then he said, 20% to Ramu. So 20% would go, out of 20 would go, what will be 20% of 20?
4.
So 4 would go there, so 10 plus 4. Then he says the balance also have to be done. And that is the 5 horses which are left have to be given to Dharmakshetra. So she distributed that and said, fine. 10 plus 4 plus 5, 19. He sat on the 20th horse and fled away. And Kamali said, "Sir, sir, stop, stop, what are you doing?" He said, "This is what I did. You said 10 to Raju, I distributed. 4 to Ramu, I gave it. 5 to Dharmakshetra, I gave it. That's the 10, that is 10 plus 4 plus 5 is 19, and the 20th horse is mine." That 20th horse, whenever you are in problem, is mine, you say. That is the Sai principle in your life. Solution for you, because God is showing the way to approach Him. So put that God feeling in your mind and you will find that things will automatically. This is the way you have to first train yourself. Then only when you go to your classes or to your center, you will be able to guide the children, the adults, the youth. That if you don't have faith, how can the others have faith? So such sort of stories you must keep in your mind, which will leave a great impression in your mind. And that's what has to be the guiding factor. Whenever in problem, bring the Sai factor in your life and there will be no problem after that. More and more. We have to be, what we think, We must have the courage to speak it and act on it. If we think something and we want to share it, then say it in clear words and then put it into your action. So therefore, if you have any doubts about certain problems, about certain things happening in the organization, do not hesitate to share it with us. We are, as I told you, just with you, wanting to help you so that we can all join hands and move in this glorious life. Let me come to the brass tacks of work. The first thing that I would like to inform you is that you are expected to do Prashanti Seva from your state, I think it's the month of January. It's the month of January. I would implore you that though there has been a little stagnation in numbers, now that period is passed. Now we believe in the omnipresence of Bhagwan. And many of you are having experiences of the omnipresence of Bhagwan. When you believe in that omnipresence, then do not hesitate to go, to come to Prashanti Malaya. We have tried our best as a Mahila Wing on its own from the whole of India to improve the Mahila Seva Dal building. I don't know how many of you have seen it now, but we have, from your own money, from your own contribution, we have changed the face of the Mahila Seva Dal building. I would implore you, whenever you go to Prashanti, then do drop in at the Mahila Seva Dal building to see what are the changes that we have brought. There's only one thing lacking now, and that is the public address system, which has to be installed on the ground floor, so that all the floors are connected by intercom. This was promised to us by the Central Trust. I have been regularly following up with the Central Trust, and I hope it will happen at its earliest. Maybe now, when I go back during the Jurist Conference, I will make it a point, because I have a meeting with the Trust, that I will remind them that there is one point from their side which has not been completed. We have completed all our agenda. We would also want them to complete this agenda of giving us a public address system, and we will be able to communicate with all inside the Seva Dal without climbing up and down and going room to room. That will be easy. There's a meeting room where you can have your meeting, and it is necessary that whoever leads the Prashanti Seva must use that room on the ground floor. I hope you are aware of that group. We had our first meeting during Guru Purnima, where all the states were present there, and they were told that you can have your meetings there. Rather than meet in corners in somebody's house or in somebody's room, it is better that you use the Mahila Seva Dal building ground floor. All the photographs of Bhagwan have been put in every room. Locks on the lockers have been put. So you have it. Everything has been maintained. Curtains have been put up. Clotheslines have been put up, whatever we felt. But if there is anything more required, please let us know, because we have funds with us and we would like to use the fund rather than let them lie stagnant there. The second important thing that we have in mind, so we must ensure that, what is the number, strength that you are supposed to take? 250? From there? 600. So we get 600? So this time we'll get 600. January 2019, we are going to get 600. I hope that's a promise from all of you, and try to get your youngsters also involved in it, because what the youngsters can do, we are now little going back in health, and therefore we need young people to help us with this. We also have taken it upon the Mahila Vibhag of all India, without your consultation, I thought, let us do something which where the Ishwarama Trust and the organization blends together. And I thought the easiest way that we can blend together without having to do too much of work, and that is to give kids to the babies, and the newborn babies. They have the mother and child care program. I said, no, we don't want to deal with the mothers, we want to deal with children, the little newborn infants. So you give us, what are the kits you give to the kids, to the little babies, and we will provide you per month with 300 kits. So if you have like a seva for 15 days, you have to only give 150 kits. The kits have, I have already today by WhatsApp sent it to every state. If any state has not received it, please let us know. And also the Mahila State Coordinator must ensure that it's passed on to every member. So that you need not only give it from your pocket. You can ask, so many people want to give, but they don't know where to give money. So you ought to buy things and give. I suggested that instead of carrying 150 packets from Delhi or Bombay or Himachal, we buy the push-up thing because it's very cheap there. You don't have to pay all those GST and CST and all those taxes. So it becomes much cheaper. The cost is about 234 plus 35 rupees for the Johnson's baby powder. So it works to about 270 rupees per kit. So multiply by 150, that is the cost. Once in a year or twice in a year which you have to incur. Now if you are doing Seva for 3 times in a year like Andhra Pradesh, we have told them not to give for 3 sessions, only to give for 2 sessions in a year. That's all that they have to do. Now the kit contains diapers, baby clothes, the little small napkins, powder, small things which a child as soon as born requires. And so I thought that nobody will say no to this because it's giving it to a child, an innocent child who has nothing in his hands, and therefore we want to own a child who's far away and needs help, and therefore touching your motherly instincts and your sisterly instincts in all of you without taking permission from you. I have already gone ahead and confirmed it, and all the Mahilas have stood by my side and said yes, we will go ahead. So if you have any problems, suppose any month later you find that there is no funds, don't worry, it's not a target that you have to reach. But it is our wish that we must, as far as possible, 150 into 270. For a state like Delhi, no problem. Think that you have one dinner less in a hotel where you're spending 10,000 and 15,000. Think that and you give it. And you feel much happier because you are helping a small, innocent child. That is the background in which we are working.
Even when we talk about Prashanti Seva, as I was just talking to the Seva Dal Center, I said for 15 days or for a week, I see you here and 600 ladies. It was such a beautiful sight in the hall. And after a week when you go back, not a single lady is to be seen in the state. You do Seva there, but is it not necessary that when you come back to your states, the same 600 ladies, if with the same force work together, it would be a different organization altogether? And I told them, I said, if there are 600 ladies, and as Swami says that every lady should be a Balvikas Guru and every house should be a Balvikas house, then there are 600 ladies here. That means today there will be 600 centers, which is not so. So that means we are part-time devotees wanting full-time grace. This is the things that we should ponder over and think. And this is really the task of not only the state Seva Dal coordinator over here, but I would request the state Seva Dal coordinator that she coordinates with all the district coordinators and takes the name of all those ladies who've been doing the Seva there to tap them at the right time, and if they are not fit to be gurus, there can be so many other things that the ladies can do. As I told them, if you're old, you cannot go and take Balvikas outside or even in your house, you feel you just cannot do it. You all can knit, you all can stitch. And I remember in Himachal, we knitted so many little Baba suits and we gave it to the general hospital, or you can even give it to the hospitals near your districts, whatever you have. So any lady, whatever potential she has and whatever kind of seva you can do, it is for us office bearers to do the needful. We cannot sit back home like this, oh, the seva was done very beautifully in Prashanti Nilayam. Beauty lies when you come back and do the work. And secondly, you know, once somebody asked, a blind man asked Swami Vivekananda, is there something worse than being blind? So what did Swamiji say? Yes, to lose one's vision. And in the Satyasai organization, the Mahila Vibhag needs to have a vision and to be very clear about your goals and your aim. And
another thing which really is disturbing us. And I remember Swami telling us in an interview once when we asked him, Bhagwan, do we have to go to somebody else to ask for certain things, or do we get the indication from you directly? And Bhagwan said, there is no via media. I am the one who gives you the direction and gives you the goal clearly. I am the one, I am the God who does everything for you. When I talk about via media, I mean that people today are running here and there, especially when Bhagwan is no more. And I know people are running after materialization. And the Lord Himself says that people run after creation and not the Creator. So be very, very clear that if Swami is no more, it's now He's having one-to-one contact with everybody. Before, it was a selected few who were getting the interview. Now it is for us to increase our sadhana so that each one of us has an interview with Swami. These are the things that we have to be very, very specific about. And I remember when we were Sevadal coordinators, we had a meeting in Whitefield, and Bhagwan came for those meetings for 6 continuous days. And one of the questions that we asked him, Swami, when we are in the organization, can we join another organization like the Lions Club or any other organization? And you know what he said? He said, you have no business, these were his words, to join any other organization, because the discipline in the SSSIC organization is very, very different. And what is that discipline? We have no mixing. As a Mahila Vibhag, we are, even as Balvikas Gurus, you see the small children, we never have programs together, the boys and girls. That's one of the disciplines. Second, there is no collection of money. There's no collection of funds. And there is no come-to-team meetings. We do not gather together to socialize. We have a business. And Swami is very particular that whatever we do it with sincerity. We do it with love. And there's a law also. And that is the discipline that He wants in the Sathya organization. These words look very tough, but then He wants quality and not quantity in the organization. And where Balvikas is concerned, Kamala, myself and Shashi, the three of us, we've been telling in the States that the residential Balvikas is now dwindling. The children are not coming so much. Either it is both sides. It's the gurus also who are not keeping pace with the fast technology, and the children too are very high tech now. They want those kind of things in the Balvikas which we are not able to provide them with. So let us now move into the schools. And it is there that we are able to get the maximum children, so that we need more and more training, so that we get those gurus and we train those teachers. And that is why we started with the Vidya Jyoti schools, where it is not now only the administrative thing that we have to look into, their structures and needs, but we are also going and we've framed a special syllabus for that Vidya Jyoti school. And in Himachal, we have got those schools and it's been so beneficial, Kamala, even now as I'll tell you. What has happened is, in the school, when we take the Balvikas and the classes, these children, once in a week, go and attend the Balvikas classes. And the government schools, the children are very poor over there. You'll have the slums children going into these government schools. They are so poor, they have only one meal a day. We have the midday meal. They have no meals, just that one meal. And now that they are, we have selected them, that wherever they are in the different areas where they stay, they go to those Balvikas classes. So residential classes are increasing, and here we enter the schools, and so both sides, they're getting the best of values, and they are even, we are fulfilling their needs. So please, it's just not the residential Balbikas. We have to come out of it and we have to enter the schools. So this is really talking about the two wings, the Balbikas and the Seva.